Hello everyone, welcome to Royal Palace online classes. So today we'll discuss the remaining problems. Question number 7.9. A series LCR circuit. There is a series LCR circuit. Connected to an alternating source of 200 volt supply, whose R value is 20 ohms, C value is 35 mu f, and L value is 1.5 Henry. When the frequency of supply equals to natural frequency of the circuit, what is the average power transferred to the circuit in one complete cycle? See, frequency of the circuit is equal to natural frequency, that means it is in resonance. During resonance, XC is equal to XL. Therefore, we will get, it acts like a pure resistor circuit, and power loss is maximum, power is equal to Vrms, Irms, cos phi, this cos phi value will be 1, that is Vrms into Irms. So, what he has given, Vrms is given, Irms is not given. Irms is equal to, what you can write, Vrms by Z, where Z is impedance. At resonance, Z is nothing but equal to R. So, just multiply, you will get the answer, 200 into 200 by 20. So this is 200 by 20 will be the answer. Just substitute the value. Vrms is 200. This is 200 by 20. That is the answer. Next question number 7.10. A radio tune over the frequency range of portion, frequency range, first frequency is 800 kilohertz, 800 into 10 power 3 hertz, and next frequency, within this frequency only this radio tune is working, 1200 kilohertz, 1200 into 10 power 3 hertz. If the LC has an effective inductance, L is equal to 200 micro Henry, 200 into 10 power 6 Henry. And LC has an effective inductance, and what is the range of variable capacitance? So what is the range, on which range capacitor will be there? See, radio tuning, I explained, during radio tuning it is an LC circuit where you will get, it is an LCR circuit where you will get resonance. At that time only we will clear, we can hear the clear sound. So this frequency is nothing but resonance frequency. You have to find the capacitance. So omega is equal to 1 by root LC. Omega is 2 pi n1 is equal to 1 by root of L. L is 200 into 10 power minus 6 into C1. This is the first cap, because in that variable capacitor will be there. What may be the capacitance range, how much, what is the least capacitor value, last, what is the highest capacitor value, that's what is asking here. So you take here N1 value, find C1, okay. Next, 2 pi N2, that is 1 by root of 200 into 10 power minus 6 into C2. Your N1 value is 800, you substitute here. Here you substitute 800, and this 1200 you can substitute here. Just find C1 and C2. That is the range, because for radio tuning, the capacitor, when you are rotating that knob, the capacitance will vary. So what is the least capacitance I can have? What is the highest capacitance I can have? So based on this frequency from radio station is releasing the frequencies from 800 to 1200 kilohertz. So if that is the case, what is the capacitance of your set required in order to receive the signal? So this is the question. So just to calculate, square it on both sides, then calculate C1, square it on both sides, calculate C2, that will be the answer, okay. So next, question number 7.11. Figure shows, there is a figure given here. Figure shows R, C and L. Figure shows a series LCR circuit connected to a variable source. Source value is 230 volts. And what is the value of R? The value of R is 40 ohms. Value of R is 40 ohms. And what is the value of C? C is 80 microfarad. What is the value of L? L is 5 Henry. Now what is asking? Determine the source frequency which drives the circuit in resonance. Is asking omega, resonance frequency. Omega is equal to 1 by root LC. This is omega is equal to 1 by root L, root of 80 into 10 power 6, 10 power minus 6, because 80 microfarad, 10 power minus 6 into C value is, this C value written, L value is 5, okay. So this if you calculate, 10 power minus 6 root you can write 10 power minus 3, that you can bring to numerator as 10 power 3 divided by root of 80 into 5 is 400, 400 root is 20, 400 root is 20, that is 10 power 3 by 20, that is 10 power 3 by 20 means 1000 by 20, it is 50 radian per second, because you are calculating omega. And next question is, obtain the impedance of the circuit and amplitude of current at the resonance frequency. At the resonance frequency, what is the impedance? Already I told, at the resonance frequency, impedance is equal to R. So that is direct question. Directly you can write resonance frequency, at resonance, impedance is equal to R. Z is equal, this is question number A. In this question, this is 7.11. In this question, first question is, this is answer for first question. Next, question B, what is asking? You can take your test book and you can see while watching the video. Next, question number B, what is the B question is, what is the impedance when it is at resonance? When it is at resonance, impedance is equal to Z is equal to R. This is B, 7.11. Because omega L is equal to 1 by omega C, it will get cancelled. Impedance formula is Z is equal to root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square. At resonance, omega L is equal to 1 by omega C. So, it will get 0, then Z is equal to R. And next question what is asking? Determine the RMS potential drops across the three elements of the circuit. Determine the RMS potential drops across the three elements of the circuit. See, here you have to find potential drops across the three elements. Potential drops across three elements is potential across resistor is equal to IRMS into R. Potential across inductor is equal to IRMS into omega L. Potential across capacitor is equal to IRMS into 1 by omega C. Okay. Now, what is the situation? IRMS you can calculate. IRMS is equal to VRMS by Z. Z you can take 40. IRMS is equal to VRMS by Z. Z you can take resonance frequency, because here frequency is not mentioned and is asking at resonance frequency only. So, therefore, IRMS is equal to VRMS by Z. Z value you can take 40, Z is equal to 40. After calculating, you can calculate the potential across resistor. Potential across resistor is IRMS into VRMS. Sorry, IRMS into R. Then after getting IRMS, you can calculate omega VL. VL is equal to IRMS into omega L. Omega you can take it as 50, IRMS into 50 into L value is 5. Next, potential across capacitor, IRMS into 1 by 50, omega we got 50 in SI system, 50 into 80 into 10 power minus 6. Just calculate IRMS from this, substitute, you will get the value. Okay, R is equal to 50. Here R is equal to 40 ohms. So, these are all the numericals what you have in a chapter called alternating current. So, next we will start electromagnetic waves in the next video class. Thank you for everyone.